Hi friends, and welcome to a new video. For those who don't know me, I'm Adalina, an artist and illustrator based in Italy, and today I want to talk about the references and how I use them. I know there are many contrasting opinions on this topic, mostly because reference images tend to be used in the wrong way. As a self-taught artist, I really understand how difficult it is to figure out all the aspects of making art, and that's why I'm doing this kind of videos, so that I can share with you what I've learned over the past few years. First, let's answer a fundamental question. Why are references so important? I want you to find the answer by doing this simple exercise. Just draw a door from your imagination. Of course, you know how to draw a door because you see doors every day in your life, but I bet a lot of us will draw the door the same exact way, a rectangle with a round handle, and that's it. It's hard to remember other details because our brain tends to simplify things and sometimes even distorts them. This is the moment we can bring in our reference. Now we can see details such as the lock, the letterbox, different window sizes, the door frame, the wood pattern, and so on. These details make your door more believable and interesting to look at. The same goes for anatomy. It's very hard to draw hands and bodies that don't look odd. Of course, if you learn how to simplify things into basic shapes, it's easier to recreate a pose from memory. But using a reference will help you add those details that make everything believable. As for the hands, I made a guide on my Patreon on how I draw and simplify them using basic shapes. In general, references are important because they train your brain to remember more details than it usually does. So if you draw the same thing from a reference over and over again, you learn how it's made and enrich your imagination with more information and details. Eventually, you'll be able to draw that thing from memory, combining all the details you have gathered during your practice. When it comes to illustration, I suggest you to put your ideas down on paper before looking for any references. Most of the times you already know what you want to draw, but you keep looking for references first because you think your ideas are not good enough. So instead of doing this, just grab a piece of paper and draw little thumbnails of things you like. It can be eating a cake, or feeding a cat, or walking in a forest, and so on. You don't have to worry about drawing properly. Just imagine a scene in your mind. But how to avoid copying the reference images? The answer is simple. Use multiple references for every aspect you need to figure out in your drawing. So in my case, I should have looked for references regarding the characters and in particular the anatomy such as hands, pose, expression, and the outfit. Then I should have figured out the bakery building, so all the aspects such as the chairs, tables, the main window, and other props such as the type of cakes, plates, ornaments, and so on. After I figure out all the main objects in my illustration, I'd still need some references for perspective, lighting, and color scheme. Of course, you may not need the references for all the aspects in your illustration. For example, I didn't use references for all the aspects of my characters, and regarding the lighting, I simply imagined the source of light and draw the shadows consequently. I usually look for references on Google and Pinterest and try to avoid all the art and illustrations so that I'm not directly influenced by the other artists. So, according to the scheme I showed you before, I start looking for bakery windows or Parisian bakery since I have a clear idea in mind. But it's okay to do a more generic research if you are not familiar with the place, and let you be inspired by what you find. I download the images and put them in the PureRef app on my computer. This application can keep all the reference images in view at all times, and the thing I mostly like is that it can stay on top of all the open programs. So for example, if I sketch in Photoshop, I'm able to see all the references without having to click back and forth. You can download this app for a few dollars. I'll let you the link in the description. So how did I use references for this particular illustration? Well, the first image that really inspired me was this one. I took the perspective and composition from it. I really loved the fact you can see part of the street in the foreground, the people in the middle ground, and also the inside of the bakery in the background. Another aspect I took from this photo is the chairs and tables design, although I changed the colors a bit and avoided the bottom part. As for the bakery window, I was really inspired by the color in this image and the structure in this other one. You can notice that I also took some of the plates and the cakes from it. This is another image that inspired me for the cakes. As for the poses and hands of the characters, I mainly took photos of myself as a reference because it's hard to find the pose you have in your mind online. Of course, I'm not going to show them here because I'm too ashamed and not in the best conditions. And these are the images I used for the characters' outfits. As for the interior of the bakery, I didn't use any references because I had a clear idea of the structure and the action, and overall this part is more forgiving because it's just an accessory to the main story and it's also on the background. So, as you can see, I didn't copy the whole thing from one single photo, but I came up with the idea and the characters and then looked for pieces that eventually built my own place and bakery. I find this process a bit time-consuming, but in the end, it's worth it. You'll finally get your own unique illustration because it contains a combination of what you love and what inspires you. By doing so, no one will ever accuse you of plagiarism because in the end, you've created something that doesn't exist anywhere in a real place. I hope you now have a clearer idea of how to use references without copying and that you'll create your unique worlds and illustrations. Thank you for watching this video and see you in the next one.